Hi, you're watching part of a series on creating more accessible Word documents. This video demonstrates how to use the built-in accessibility checker. Word has a built-in tool that checks your document for accessibility issues. The accessibility checker makes it much easier to identify and repair accessibility problems. Like any automated checker, it still relies on you to check some things. For example, it can't tell you whether certain text needs to be a heading or whether the alt text used in an image is appropriate. However, I highly recommend using it to help you make your document as accessible as possible. Some people use the accessibility checker as the first step in evaluating their document. Others use it as the final step after they have fixed the accessibility issues they recognized on their own. There's no right or wrong. I encourage you to use it whenever you want, whenever it makes sense to you. In this video series, I'm choosing to use it as the final step. To use the checker, go to File, Info, which should be the default, Check for Issues, Check Accessibility. It opens in the right sidebar, and notice that results are grouped in three categories: Errors, Warnings, and Tips. Errors are the most important issues to fix, with warnings the next most important. I can mouse over each category name to be reminded of what they do. Errors indicate content that people with disabilities are unable to read. The issue prevents them from getting information. That's why errors are the most important issues to fix. Warnings indicate content that people with disabilities find difficult to read. The issue makes it confusing or frustrating to get the information, and it may take more time. Tips indicate content that people with disabilities might find difficult to read. The checker is telling us it's not sure if this is a problem and wants us to check it out. I'm going to start by working on the error in my document. Here's a feature of the accessibility checker that I really like. When I click on an item in the results, it shows me where that issue is located in the document. And did you notice what happened below the inspection results? When I clicked on Picture 1, the checker provided additional information about why this issue should be fixed, and under that, step-by-step instructions for how to fix it. I found that to be a helpful feature. Now back to my document. The checker is telling me that this image is missing alt text. In the context of my document, however, I've decided that this is a decorative image. Recall that alt text for decorative images should be blank. So in this case, I know more than the checker tool. I know it's a decorative image that doesn't need alt text, so I can choose to ignore this error message for missing alt text.
This has been How to Use the Built-in Accessibility Checker.